we do have a little bit of a problem. We just have to stop always putting race in the mix. It can be out.
Do you think then they should take off Black Lives Matter on the road right there if we want to get rid of dividing races or picking one out of things? Should we get rid of the Black Lives Matter?
Not yet. I do believe all lives matter, but I do believe in the end, until you fully understand there's a problem with the Black community, then no lives matter.
As you guys can see, as I promised you, we were back out on the road doing interviews, talking to people, but I need you guys to support me at patreon.com/Kaitlin Bennett for travel expenses, security costs, and just be able to bring you awesome content. You can support my work there, patreon.com/Kaitlin Bennett.
Hey,
Asian boy.
What's your name?
My name's Kaitlin. What's your name?
Katrina. We don't need to say, the black girl over there with the hat. Oh yeah, her with the strut. Like, no. Oh,
yeah, this white girl with the 100 SPF because she burns so easily. We don't say that.
Let's just stop saying that so it won't be a problem anymore. That's where we have to try to fix it within ourselves too. Because we do have a little bit of a problem. We just have to stop always putting race in the mix. It can be out.
Do you think then they should take off Black Lives Matter on the road right there if we want to get rid of dividing races or picking one out of things? Should we get rid of the Black Lives Matter?
Not yet.
But we're talking about we don't want to separate based on the races.
I know, but we still have to get to that point. But like I said, until we both come to the understanding that Black lives does matter because of all the stuff that they've been through, and let it be known that it is a problem and never went away, until that is acknowledged, then all lives matter. You see what I'm saying? Then all that can come off once that is finally acknowledged, that
Think in America in 2020 that you don't think everyone agrees that Black lives matter, that humans, do you think everyone agrees that white lives matter?
Honestly, I believe all white lives matter. I do believe that.
But do you think America as a whole would agree with you that white lives matter just like black lives matter? Because if you take a poll...
No.
No.
You don't think so?
No. Mm-mm. Not all Americans would believe. No. Because I do believe America is still based on white. It's the truth. You guys are the dominant. And sorry, take that back. Don't need to say you guys, but the dominant, like...
Are we dominant or are we the majority of a skin color? Because when you say we're dominant, you're implying that we have dominance over people, which is not true. I don't believe in systemic racism. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a police brutality problem against people of color in America. That's statistically not true. It's not happening. And we can dive into that. But if we look at the statistics and we look at the crime rates and we look at who is being brutalized by the police, it's not a racial problem.
I don't agree with you at that at all.
Do you mind if I take 10 seconds to try to change your mind?
Go ahead.
So, 13.
I was going to knowledge.
Yes.
Well, knowledge is power.
So because you didn't know that about Black Lives Matter and their mission statement and everything about... Yeah, so... With everything going on, and I'm sure, I don't want to put words in your mouth, but you believe with the Black Lives Matter movement, there's probably a police brutality problem within the black community, right? You think they're a target? I don't want to put words in your mouth, but is that something you would say yes?
Yeah, because just the reality is how many black people are in jail right now, in prison. Look at that number.
Okay. Let's talk about how many unarmed black men were shot in 2019 by the police, shot and killed.
I don't know how many men that...
With everything going on, it's painted on our streets, there's riots happening, there's protests happening. Would you think that number is substantial? Because we're just talking about it nonstop. Black Lives Matter, police brutality. If you had to put a number on it, what would you guess? What range?
I wouldn't know. I would just say it's a good number, because in the end, it doesn't even matter about the number. The reality is, if he just felt threatened and this person was unarmed and you didn't follow procedure and went ahead and shoot him, I'm sorry, you felt threatened because of his color. That's how I feel.
I think the numbers do matter, because when we look at the numbers, we find that 9 unarmed black men were shot and killed by the police. All came back justified except for 2, and the officers were held accountable for that. So if you would like more interactions like these and behind the scenes footage of how we got here, that's actually the first people we talked to, you can go to libertyhangout.tv right now to support my work to keep coming out here. And trying to show these people what the truth is, but look at them right there. She has her phone in her hand. I hope she's looking up what systemic racism is. She'll find out it doesn't exist.
There's a lot of numbers that are out there we don't know. The cops keep it within themselves. You think they don't do things
well,
to
let's,
keep things
let's,
together?
Let's do a hypothetical. Let's pretend it's not just something that they made up. Let's pretend these are the numbers. Does that shock you that it was 9?
9's still too many.
I agree with you, but does it shock you?
No, it doesn't.
Is it surprising?
No, it's not surprising, because how I feel, I'm like, 9 is a number, but still, the reality is, how many black people are in prison?
Why do you think more black people are in prison?
Exactly.
Why do you think?
Because I do believe racism is still alive. Like, every little thing is like, oh, let's go ahead and put this guy in there instead of that same other race guy can do the same exact thing, but he get a lesser charge than that person. That is a problem.
Well, do you think it's purely by... Okay, give me the numbers. Do you know the population, the percentage of population in America that is African-Americans, black people?
That are in prison?
No, just the population in general. No. So it's 13% of the population are black people.
Okay.
They commit, black people commit, that 13% of the population, over 50% of violent crimes in our country. Do you think that might account for why there are more black people in prison or the jail or the system?
But why do you think it's 50%? Why? That means you're saying black people are troublemakers.
I'm not saying that. Those aren't my words.
I know.
But if you get that from the numbers, mm-hmm. If that's what the numbers say, then that might explain why there are more black people in our prison systems. No, you don't. You think it's racism?
I do believe, because like I said, in the end, once we, yes, we knowledge is power, but yes, numbers with 9 people all together got killed from police. Okay, still it's 9 too many, and still how many people are in prison? Still, that's a lot of people. So you can't just tell me, oh, automatically, just. Well, black people, you just need to stop doing stupid stuff. Like,
well, I didn't say that.
No, I know you didn't say that. I'm not saying that you said that. But in general, I'm taking it from my opinion, from what I'm hearing, is like, still at the same time, it is a problem.
Well, maybe. I just want to maybe give you the idea that maybe you could walk away from this and think that maybe it's not because of racism. Maybe it's because the black community does commit more crime. That would make their communities more policed. You don't think it's possible that they commit that much crime?
No, I actually don't.
Why not?
I don't. Because the amount of people, if you say there's like, with 13%, how many percent is the white people?
I think it's about, I want to say 60, because there's a whole bunch 60. Of other races.
So there's 60. All right, just say 60. Just use that number. We have 13, and 30% predominantly, most of them are bad. Versus the reality is, most of these serial killers, who are they? Who are the people that actually shoot up schools? Who are the people that actually shoot up in Los Angeles? Who are they?
Well, 9% of the country are black men. They commit more than 50% of all murders in the country. All murders of any.
Serial killers. If we start with serial kills, because I'm one of those people that I'm really into investigations.
True crime.
True crimes, crime junkie. I'm a crime junkie fan. No, there's a lot of 60%. You said 60%, right? Of them that they do a lot of crazy crimes.
They sure do.
All of a sudden, we're the ones that, because we're such a small number, we're 13 compared to you. We're the most dangerous ones.
I'm not saying you're the most dangerous, and I don't want you to think that I'm saying that or claiming that about the black community. I'm not. But I really want you to maybe look at, instead of looking at TV shows and documentaries and things that want to grab your attention, look at the statistics. 9% of the population in America are black men. Over 50% of murders in our country. Murders. So when you want to talk about serial killers, those are added into their murders.
If you want to be realistic.
Because we're not talking about, we're not chanting white lives matter. We're talking about black lives matter. Black people are chanting this.
Though, what is the main reason why black lives matter? Because they just want to let it be known that, hey, me, we have a problem here, just acknowledge me.
But what is the problem? Is the problem the police, or is the problem within their community?
The problem is, accept me, I'm not a bad person.
No, I don't think anybody thinks that, but the statistics
show that you guys think that. Just think about it. So you just
I think
say,
that
statistics shows that you think that black people are bad.
No. Statistics can't show what people think. Statistics just show what the reality is. And we can look at statistics and graphs and things that have been collected over decades, and we can see where the problems might be within these communities that are destroying the cities right now. We can look at these statistics and we can maybe narrow down where the issue might be. And if we want to solve issues, I tell you what, Black Lives Matter is not the place we need to look for solving issues with police brutality when they want to take the fathers out of the home. You remove the fathers, you destroy the nuclear family for children that need to grow up in a stable family structure. Their odds of committing crime and going to jail skyrocket. I don't know why we say black people have an issue with the police and then want to make their risk of getting involved in the police go up. I would encourage you to look at their mission statement and then look at the statistics about what happens when we take fathers out of the home, especially for the black community. It is detrimental to them.
I think it was a few weeks ago, I don't know, some guy was just trying to go in a car with his kids, three kids. I don't know that. No. I don't know the full story about that, but based on what I've seen so far, you can't tell me that's not a problem.
Well,
but it's still
I would like to talk about that. Because if you don't know the full story, he had a warrant out for his arrest for sexual offenses and domestic violence. And he was involved in an altercation. He was fighting with the police. He actually had, I think, an object in his hand. I don't want to say a knife because I don't know for sure. He had an object in his hand fighting with the police. And they told him not to go in the car because he had said, I have a gun in the car. So he was going into the car.
What about the guy that actually just fell and that they literally blatantly killed and put?
Who?
Whatever, I forgot his name. That's bad.
But it was George Floyd.
George Floyd.
Did you watch any body cam footage? Hold on. Did you watch any body cam footage?
Yes, I actually did. I did watch the body cam footage.
And he was saying he can't breathe. I can't breathe. He said, yes. So he said I couldn't breathe several times, saying he's claustrophobic. He can't get. And you're laughing, but I don't think it's funny because we've now destroyed our city. Why is that funny though?
She doesn't want to be recorded.
Hey, listen,
okay. Let's come. If you, I mean, we are in public. And if you want to record us, I welcome it. I love being on camera. It's great. But you are in public. Seriously, if you think there's an issue, I don't want any problems, but call the police if there is an issue. But I would encourage you.
Don't record her. Just don't record her.
Like, right. But she's laughing at a situation that is detrimental to our country.
That's
right.
Her opinion. It's your opinion. The same thing like I'm
It's not an opinion. What happened in the body cam footage, it's not an opinion.
About what happened.
Oh, I'm not talking about feelings. I am talking about facts about what happened.
It's an opinion how you feel about the facts. That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay, that is an opinion.
How you feel about the facts.
It sure is.
Versus my opinion, how I feel about the facts. I'm not trying to get an argument because personally it doesn't affect me. Because in the end, what bound to happen is bound to happen. I'm not going to be stressed over this. I do believe all lives matter, but I do believe in the end, until you fully understand there's a problem with the black community, then no lives matter. But I am a firm believer of all lives matter. I'm one of those people. But at the same time, we all need to fully understand each other's side.
You keep saying to understand each other's sides, but you keep telling me things that aren't happening, and it's right there in the body footage.
I'm trying to explain things that I see that's going on, and you're like, well, no, that's not facts.
Justin, what is this?
Let's just
I don't know. I feel like we should end this because I don't know what's going on.
Okay. It was nice,
Justin,
meeting you guys.
It is Katrina. It was great meeting you. I appreciate the conversation.
I have no hard feelings.
No hard feelings at all. You're a stranger. I can't have hard feelings towards you. Katrina was amazing. Katrina was a very respectful person that I feel like was halfway open to listening to a conversation. I think she has a little bit of bias that is clouding her ability to see the truth of what's happening and what Black Lives Matter is and what is going on in the George Floyd case. Unfortunately, her friend, I mean, she's still laughing. She started laughing when I started talking about the truth about what happened with George Floyd. When we pointed the camera over at her, because she had a big old smile on, you'd think that she'd want to be in the frame there. She looked like she was ready for the camera, broke down in tears. She was all of a sudden a victim. But what she doesn't understand is that she's in public and she can be filmed. If she doesn't want to do it in public, she shouldn't be out here. I don't know what this gentleman on the bike was supposed to do for her. I don't know why she went crying to him. But these are the situations we get in when someone wants to be rude or wants to be unprofessional or wants to be a little giddy, a little girl. And then they don't want to take the heat when they get called out on it. So don't forget, guys, for uncut and behind the scenes footage, you can go to libertyhangout.tv. It's a good time to figure out how we do things here, what it looks like as we're trying to film these incredible interactions. libertyhangout.tv. It's a good time.